All right, you are welcome to Deep Tooth Academy, where we are devoted to building academic excellence in students, especially in the STEM subjects. In our video today, we are going to be looking at how you can use your calculator to solve for questions on fractions. We want to look at fractions, but before we go ahead, we need to understand the three types of fractions so that we can see how we can put them into the scientific calculator. Those three types of fractions include the proper fractions, in which the numerator, that is the number on top, is greater than the denominator, the number at the base. So for example, we have 5/7, then you can see 5 is less than 7, and we have 3/5, and again 3 is less than 5. If you want to input that into the calculator, this is the fraction button, so you can just press that. I want to input the numerator. Let's say we want to put 3/5, we have 3, and you can press this next button to input the value of the denominator, 5, and you can press equal to, and you can see this is 3/5 as shown on the calculator. You can follow along with this key log so that you can also get out your calculator. Don't just watch the video, follow along. Let's practice together. Okay, now in the case of improper fractions, we can see that in this case the numerator is greater than the denominator, and that's why we have 8/3. 8 is the numerator, it's greater than 3, which is the denominator. We can also have another example, 17/5. Let's input that. So we'll press our fraction sign, and you put the value for the numerator, 17. Press forward, and you put the value of the denominator, 5. And we can press equal to, and you can see this is 17/5. Now, look at this button, the SD button. That is converting whatever you are getting as your answer from the standard form to the decimal form. So we are working with fraction. So it's taking this as a standard for what your inputs, and to convert to decimal, we can just press this. So 17/5 is the same as 3.4. Now, interestingly, before I go to mixed numbers, if you look at the shift function on top of the SD button, you can see this is actually a representation of a whole number, a numerator, and a denominator, or you convert to just a numerator and a denominator. And for this particular improper fraction in which the numerator is greater than the denominator, we can actually press shift SD button to give us a mixed number. You can see this mixed number, that 17/5 is actually 3/2/5 as seen on the display. And that's actually correct, because we have 5 times 3 is 15, 15 plus 2 is 17, and we can say that's the value of numerator over the value of denominator, which is 5. Okay. But if you want to input a mixed number, how do we go about that? And that is what we go to say, if you want to input 3/2/5, so we need to use this shift function on the fraction button. So we have shift fraction button, and you can see we have the mixed number input function there on the display. Our whole number is 3, the numerator is 2, and the denominator is 5. All right. So doing that, you can just press the equal to button, and you can see it's also giving us 17/5. So now with this preparation, we now know how to input fraction into the scientific calculator. We can go ahead and look at some solved examples. And if you are ready, of course, you have to be ready. Take that calculator and that worksheet. Let's get our hands dirty. And here is our very first example that we're going to be solving together. And you can see, normally in the order of operation, when we are carrying out BODMAS or PEMDAS, as some used to call it, now we need to express first the expression that is put in bracket. Just like for BODMAS, you have bracket of division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. So we need to carry out the operation in the bracket first before carrying out this other operation that is outside of the bracket. But okay, we don't need to trouble ourselves with that. The calculator is going to understand this. We just need to know the way to input it in the scientific calculator. So let's start with our opening brackets, right? And then the next value is 3/4. That is just a proper fraction. So you put in, we press the fraction button, we put in the value for the numerator 3 and the value for the denominator 4. Okay. And now I make it the habit to also press this forward button so that I can input the sign minus minus another proper fraction. Okay, the fraction, the numerator is 2 and the denominator is 3, and then I want to close that bracket. And just like that, I've closed the bracket, then multiply by. Now, 10 number 1 over 5 is a mixed number. So I need to press shift fraction sign to activate this function written on top of the fraction and input the value for my mixed number. The whole number is 1, the numerator is 1, and the denominator is 5. And a good habit for you to check, do you input the value correctly? And if you have ascertained that that is correct, just press your equal to. So the simplification of this particular question is 1 over 10. Okay, and with that, we are through with this question. Okay, hold on. More work coming along. Let's move on to our next example. All right, this is another example. But first, we need to be able to interpret this question correctly. Like here, we're having a set of fractions constituting the numerator and another set of fractions constituting the denominator. Now, the best thing to do in this case is that we first carry out the operation of the numerator and put it in brackets, now divided by the set of fractions in the denominator. So I will first put the numerator in brackets. So I'm having my opening bracket. Now I'm having mixed numbers all through. That means I press shift fraction button. So the whole number in the first case is 2, the numerator is 1, the denominator is 2. I press my forward button to carry out the operation plus. Okay, another mixed number, so shift fraction. I have 1 whole number, 3 over 4, okay, and then divided by another mixed number, 1 whole number, 2 over 5. All right, okay, now I need to close my bracket, and I've just done that. Divided by, so this long division is actually division. That's why I'm carrying out the division operation, and I want to put the whole of the entries in the denominator also in bracket. Okay, so I want to input the mixed number, 2 number, 1 over 4, all right, minus another mixed number, 1 whole number, 1 over 2. So I can close that bracket. And now, as a rule of thumb, it's best that you just go back, look at the things that you have input into the calculator to ascertain that you didn't make any mistake. And once you are through with that, you just press the equal to sign. And the solution to this particular question is the whole number 5. Okay? So here in this question, we are being given a word problem and we are being asked that by how much is the sum of 3 whole number 2 over 3 and 2 whole number 1 over 5? Less than 7. Now the hint to this question is that we need to know that the sum of 3 whole number 2 over 3 and 2 whole number 1 over 5 should be calculated first, and that sum is going to be subtracted from 7. So this is how our expression is going to be. This is the interpretation of the word problem that we are given, and this is what we need to input into the calculator. So having understood that, we can now say we have 7 minus, we open our brackets, a mixed number, we want to put in 3 whole number 2 over 3, okay, plus another mixed number, here we have 2 whole number 1 over 5, okay, and we can close that bracket and cross checking to see that there's no error, there's no mistake. You can press the equal to and look at this. Our answer is obtained as an improper fraction. And if you remember that definition, it is that the numerator, the number on top, is greater than the denominator, the number below. So 17, of course, is greater than 15. And that is also telling you that you can also express this as a mixed number. And if you remember correctly, what we need to press is shift SD button. And that means that 17 over 15 is the same as 1 whole number 2 over 15, and of course 15 times 1 is 15 plus 2 is 17, so we have 17 over 5. Now as a rule of thumb, just following along with this lecture is not the best means for you to gain proficiency in this. For you to gain proficiency, you need to get your hands dirty, lay your hands on some questions and attempt them with your own calculator. And that is why coming up now, you are going to have some DIY. Okay, this is a DIY, or you can call it an assignment, that I want you to actually attempt on your own. And what I want you to do is, whatever answer you get in the two questions, put it in the comment section so that we can see that you are truly following along and you are making attempts to build that proficiency. Okay, that is the feedback that will tell us to know, that will allow us to know that truly you are following and you are giving in your chip, you are putting in your own effort to build that academic excellence. Now, we want you to just go ahead, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, share with your friends, share with your loved ones. The fact that you are subscribing is showing us that yes, what we are doing is contributing one thing or the other to build academic excellence with you, and it will help us to actually put in more effort, do more, so that academic excellence you can truly achieve. It's Dave Tooth Academy, and until next time, God bless you.